Hello everyone, my name is Ashfaq Ahmed and I am PhD and postdoc in structure biology and bioinformatics. Today we will talk about Illustrator for biological sequences. Actually, I will teach you how to use Illustrator for biological sequences. It is very interesting video and I hope, in fact, I'm sure that most of you will love this video. So before going to start this video, I want to tell you something. I have received few messages and few queries, and some people are complaining that the video quality I'm making is not so good, and as per their messages, it is like this. If you are seeing, it's like this. So I want to show you that when you are viewing my video in YouTube, you need to click this button. It's setting button, click, and here in the quality section, just select 720. So when you select the best quality, it will be readable and it will be in a very good quality. But for that, if you do not have a stronger internet connection, you may experience some pauses, but that's okay. At least you will have a good quality of video. So let's move to our original video. So okay, let me show you something first. Have you ever seen such kind of figures in books, in research papers, in thesis, in assignments, or even on the different pages of internet? See this one? Now also see this one. Okay, so in this today video, I will show you how you can draw these pictures, how you can draw these figures for your data, for your thesis, for your research paper, or for your assignment. So let's move. We will use a program. So making these figures are very simple and simpler, in fact, and I will show you how you can make these figures. So first of all, you will need a program, and the program name is IBS, Illustrator for Biological Sequences. So how you can download this program? Please, for download link, see description of this video. I will put the downloadable link for this program in the description section, so you can just click there, and that will lead you to the download page. You can download and install into your computer, and on the double click you will have this kind of window. So suppose it has two modes. You can see a protein mode and a nucleotide mode. So if you are trying to draw a protein sequence and its different domains, or I would say different mutations, or whatever you want to draw, so you have to click this mode. Otherwise, in the case of nucleotide, you have to click this mode. So I'm demonstrating this mode. Let's say double click on protein and just say enter. When you enter, it will look like this, the cuckoo group and some toolbars here, and okay, also some toolbar here that says protein domain, sites, cut line, node, and zoom and grayscale. So let's start. For example, I have a protein and it has amino acid sequence of let's say 300. So first of all, I will click the protein, and it says the start sequence. If it has a name, for example, I say A kinase. For example, this is the name of my protein, so I will write here A kinase. Start is from 1 and end is, let's say, 300 amino acid. and I want to show these number, so or not. So if I want to show, I can show it down, I can show it up, and even I can hide it. You can see it will be like this. And how much height I want, let's say I need it 50. Okay, and for the vertical stuffs you can also put some value here, but it's very easy, so you can try by yourself, you will find it. And for the colors, let's say I'm selecting it this orange color, okay. And for the gradient, I'm selecting this gradient. And for the texture, let's say I'm selecting none, that's okay. And the font size, I'm selecting 14. And the line size, let's say 2. And the dash, if you want, so that's okay. The line color, okay, so just okay. You see, now if you think that there are something you need to change it, like the line colors are black, you want it green, or you want also want it orange, this is down, this is up, you can again click here and just quickly make it both down. And the line color, let me change it to some this one, okay. Okay, so now you can see both are down, the line color is also it's matchable. Now if you want to make it a thinner, smaller, you can make real-time changes, just like height. I am going to select it 30 and let's see. Okay, yes. Now if you want to present some domains, like this protein has two domains. The first domain is called let's say D1, and it starts from our amino acid number 25 and it ends on amino acid number 125. And if you want to show it also, you can use the same thing again, and you can name it or you can, if you want to include some domain name, I say D1 again. The font size is 20, I will make it 14. Okay, so no issue, you can, let's say this color, all these things are okay. So see, now if there is some mutations, for example, if there is some site which has been, so you can also mention that mutation, like click on the site, for example, position number 100, and it is alanine, change to alanine 100, change to leucine A 100 to L, with font size, text color, and which sign you want to show. Let's say I'm using okay, this is fine. The color I want to show, let's say red. Okay, the angle, if I want to rotate it, let's say this one with zero. Okay, just click okay. Now you can see it's 100 at position 2. Now you, if you want to make it more a bit smaller, so you can even drag it this way, or you can even make it bigger this way. Okay, now you think that if you think that no, I need some angle, so double click again in this panel and just give them some rotation angle. Let's say I'm giving 30 degree, let's say. See, okay, the rotation angle, it is for the ball, the spherical ball. Okay, now if you want some central x 100 and central x 50, if you want also, just make it, let's see how it goes. You see, now you can also make it manually, change it manually. In fact, in some cases you have two mutation, or if you want to show two mutations, so the one is originating to the left and the other will originate to the right. So once again, if you want to add another domain, click the domain again and Let's say it starts from 150 and it ends on the 250, and its name is, let's say, D2. So just enter here. If you want a D2 a different color, just click it again here, and let's say I'm selecting a green, smashing green. Okay, so you can make this kind of figure. You can also make some cut line like this if you need it, or if you all these things are possible. You can also make some note, so try by yourself. I think it's a very beautiful program. You can take a lot of help from these programs, and it will reshape your story, it will reshape your manuscript or paper, or it will reshape your thesis, whatever your assignment. So work smart and go smart. If you like my video, subscribe the channel, and I will bring such kind of interesting stuff as well as educational stuff, as well as I'm planning to present you a very, to give you a very solid ideas of different topics in aspects of bioinformatics analysis. So the finally, how will you save this figure? Is it possible? So yes, it is possible. Just click file and export image. And the good thing about this program, you can export a higher DPI image. Let's say I'm exporting 600 DPI, and remember, all the good journals, publishing journal, they requires at least 300. So this program gives you 600 DPI with a lot of other options. So if you want, this will manage the size of the figure, and just write, if you want to write the name, so just include the name. Otherwise okay, where I want to save this figure, I want to save this figure, let's say desktop. And what name I want to give it? Let's say I want to give it let's say test one. Okay, save and export. Now let's see, do we have this figure on desktop? So okay, it's here, test one. Wait, yeah, this one, you can see it again. Yeah, this is your figure which we created now. So I hope you will like it, and subscribe the channel. Be with me, and sorry for some voice distortion. My basic, or my main focus is not on basically my main focus is to give you some quality stuff, not to give you some quality editing. And the reality is I'm also not very good in editing things and all these things. So bear with this kind of things if you feel some inconvenience, and drop your question in comment section. If you want me to cover some specific title for you or specific stuff for you, thank you. Stay happy, all the best, bye bye.